Saturday we scored 2 goals.
Mm. Today we didn't
today
score.
We didn't score any goal. Mm.
Today, last Saturday,
how is that an improvement?
Saturday we conceded 3.
No,
today we didn't concede.
I think we put so much pressure on our team. Mm. Yes, we're African champions. Tunde mentioned Burkina Faso. They didn't go to the World Cup. They didn't go to the World Cup.
Mm.
Our players had, you know, had a busy 2 months. These are human beings. And they were given extended break.
What about Nigeria that went to the World Cup?
See, yes, they didn't do well, you know, in Calabar. But we drew. If we had lost, then I mean that would have been a disaster.
Mm.
But they drew.
Let's go to
what about Cameroon that went to the World Cup?
Cameroon they left in the first round. They had enough.
But they went to the World Cup.
Hold on, Alaba is joining us from Ibadan. Alaba, how is Ibadan receiving this news of the Eagles getting a point of South Africa? And how are you receiving it as well?
In a fair game. Hello.
Yeah, go ahead, Alaba. Go ahead.
It's a fair game. I have to comment to you. And today for your program, you will make my evening.
Did the Eagles make your evening today, Alaba? Did the Eagles make your day today?
No, they didn't make my day. My only advice is we need a creative midfielder.
Creative midfielder.
That's the problem we're having. Within if you look at the circle of the midfield. There is a link in the midfield. That's the problem we're having in the Nigerian football.
Okay. Today, thank you.
Alaba.
I beg your pardon, Alaba. Thank you so much for giving your contribution and making it short, straight to the point. You've raised your point. Alaba has raised a very crucial point. Guys, let's talk about it very quickly. Creative midfield play. Because Tunde raised the point yesterday, and I think that point also came to the fore today. When you're playing against a team that doesn't want you to score, you have to devise a means to score goals and win games. Because if you don't score goals, you don't win games.
Yeah.
And we saw the South Africans today, second half, they told themselves, look, a point is okay for us, gives us 4 points, which is better than losing.
And keeps us ahead of Nigeria.
And we couldn't just break them down. Well, Osagona came in, had a few chances here and there, but we need to know how to break down opponents and get goals when we need to win games.
Absolutely, to him. You know, but between now, we are in September, between now and October, whatever is the issue could be resolved. But the issue of a creative midfield problem has always been there.
Yeah.
You know, a decade. You know, and Mikel has not lived up to expectation. You know, everybody is saying drop him. But Keshi has stuck with this guy. So I don't know how he's going to do it. We have Joel Obi on the bench. We have some players who he could bring in. But
is Joel Obi a creative? I mean, let's look at the options available to us.
No, he has done it on Asiasia.
Mm.
He came in.
No, he was always there with Mikel. But what is the problem? Problem with a creative?
Let me just say something very quickly.
Yeah.
You see, football is very easy when you understand a certain principle. That there are 3 ways to break down the opposition defense. You either go above it, you go beside it, or you go through it. Now, you have to decide how it is. That means at every point in time, you must have 3 game plans as to how to break down the opposition. And today we saw a team that did not know how to go above, beside, or even through an opposition. So that means there's something clearly wrong with their thought processes. I've talked about how their approach play has been shambolic, to say the least. How they are, you know, at when you get to this level of football, towards the end, I mean, when you get close to your position, you understand how they defend. Do they defend individually or in packs? Do you decide whether that is when you start playing 1-2 touches, quick touches on the edge of the opposition in order to break your opposition down? Fine, if you can't do that, you go through the wings and try to open the opposition. But if you open up through the wings, who are the players in the middle waiting to receive it? Are you playing a target man? Are you playing a support striker to run off the target man's knockdowns? All these things they're elementary parts of football. And from what I saw today, I did not see a team that knew about how to go about its business.
Mm. Let me read a few comments on Twitter. I'm going to come back to you guys later on to throw up options, because we have identified some of the problems in the team. We need to also be able to provide solutions. Who are the options available to us? A few people on Twitter are saying, where's that tweet? That's just gone down. A lot of tweets coming in. Somebody was saying, Sunday Mba showed that it was a creative force for us at the Nations Cup. Where is Sunday Mba? That's the question he's asking.
Sunday Mba has gone into oblivion.
We don't know where Sunday Mba is. Olayiwola says, tonight's match shows that Nigeria is lacking discipline and our bench is poor. Keshi needs to step up. Kende Oyeleke. I'm told we have Hassan on the line from Ilorin. Hassan, we're going to come to you in a minute. Let me just read this tweet from Kende Oyeleke. If Nigeria had beaten Congo last Saturday, most Nigerians will have seen tonight's result as okay. All right, so let's go to Hassan in Ilorin. Hassan, what's your own reaction to the game? Good, bad, very poor, not too bad, fair? What can you tell us?
The game it wasn't too bad, but Kessie who can move with the ball, and he also needs somebody that can put the ball into the net. You see, I don't know what is happening to Mikel or Nancy. They were too weak in the midfield, so he needs somebody that can move with the ball, and he also needs somebody that can put the ball into the net. Eminike did his best, but the supporting striker, they are not playing with him at all. So he should try and do something on this. Thank you.
All right, so it's the same problem that Hassan has identified with the Super Eagles, a lack of creativity. We need to get plenty of options into that department. But let's look at it very quickly before the next call comes in, or before I read someone's tweets. Who are the options, or what options are available for us in that creative department? Before Mikel came, we had a Ruben Gabriel. Unfortunately, Ruben Gabriel got injured for a long time. Hold on. When Mikel wasn't there, we had a Ruben Gabriel who was playing in that position for us, and he was running. Not exactly that kind of creative player, but he was full of energy, and he was always there, bringing plenty of energy to the midfield. But we've tried Sunday Mba, gave us the Nations Cup success. What other options are available to us, gentlemen? There's people who talk about Lukman Haruna, people talk about Ramon Aziz. Where can we get a replacement for?
I think the problem is from the bench, honestly. Because with these same players, we can achieve a decent result. I don't know why Keshi is not talking to John Mikel Obi. He needs that sense of urgency. He's slowing down our game. And when you have strikers in good position and the man who's supposed to distribute the ball is delaying, there's no way you get the goals. So he needs to talk to these guys and, let them bring that sense of urgency. We saw Emenike, alone up front, no link-up play, nobody to support him. And so I think it's a problem of the coach. We can get the results.
Let me read a few comments on Twitter very quickly. Kelvin Amata says Keshi has lost the script. He has to add Iheanacho and Moses to the team. These are no Eagles. That's what he says. Okay, Mustafa is calling us from Bida. In Niger State, Bida in Niger State. Mustafa, how is Niger receiving the results? Mustafa?
Hello?
Mustafa, you have to mute the audio so that we can talk to you on the program.
The audio from your TV screen.
Hello? Move the volume on your TV and talk to us, Mustafa.
We are from Juvic. Hello?
Go ahead, Mustafa.
Hello?
Go ahead, Mustafa. Looks like we've lost contact with Mustafa. So let me just... Victor Moses, yeah. Kelechi Iheanacho. I mean, these are names that are also popping up.
They are good options.
Good
Victor
options
Moses
for Nigeria.
Seems to be rebuilding his career now with Stoke City. He's also a good option. Kelechi Iheanacho, we have a problem in Nigeria where we believe that.
Do we rush Kelechi?
We say he's too young, but he's under 20 now, which means he's in the intermediate level. I mean, we've seen 19-year-old Raheem Sterling play for what? For England. We've seen a 19-year-old Munir El Haddadi play for Spain. If you are good enough, you are old enough. And that's my belief. And there's a kind of arrogance, a kind of urgency, a kind of freedom that youth brings to a team that you cannot find from other players. And again, you have to look at the players that they're a disgrace. These are the same players who are fighting tooth and nail for a largesse at the World Cup that they wanted at all costs, that we had to fly all the way there. And they have not justified the faith and investments we put in them.
Do you think that's the way to go? Let's begin to introduce Kelechi Iheanacho, MVP at under-17 level, and see if he can learn so quickly, and we can then draft him into the team. Is that an option for us?
No, you cannot close your team. Keshi has shown
your
that
it's always
open. The problem is that
he has complete the rebuilding process.
He has talked to some set of players. Victor Moses, for me, is a creative player, undoubtedly, and he should be in that team. Whether you like it
if
or not.
If he's in good form, if he's in good shape.
I mean, he has played for his new club. He has played two matches already. So why are you dropping him? If we are saying that we have creative problems, you know, the most creative player for me in that team is Victor Moses. Mm. And if you drop him, then where are we heading?